हे दोस्तों नमस्ते। आज का जो सेशन है ये थोड़ा लंबा जा सकता है। इट कैन गेट एक्सटेंडेड टू मोर देन 10 to 15 minutes बिकॉज द टॉपिक दैट वी आर टॉकिंग टुडे अबाउट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। इट इज़ क्रूशियल, इट इज़ क्रिटिकल। ये थोड़ा गंभीरता के साथ लेने वाला विषय है। चक्रों के बारे में हम लोग बात करने वाले हैं। इसके बारे में बहुत सारी मिथ्याएँ हैं। देर इज़ अ लॉट ऑफ मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन इज कनेक्टेड विद अ लॉट ऑफ पावर प्ले एंड तंत्रा एंड मिरेकल्स। सो आई विल ट्राई टू बस्ट अ फ्यू एंड आई विल ट्राई टू टेल यू वट एग्जैक्टली आर द मिथ्स। आई विल ऑल्सो टॉक अबाउट द लॉजिक ऑफ इट एंड दैट इट इज़ अ कम्प्लीट साइंस। ये पूरा अपने तरीके का एक विज्ञान है जो अगर हम चाहें तो हम इसको बढ़ा सकते हैं। एंड इट इज़ मोर रिलेटेड टू अवर ओन एनर्जी, अवर ओन इंटेलेक्ट एंड अवर ओन स्मार्टनेस। और जितना आप इसको ज़्यादा इस्तेमाल करेंगे ये उतना ज़्यादा बढ़ता जाता है। ओके, सो इट इज़ एग्जैक्टली लाइक कीपिंग योर प्रैक्टिस। वंस यू स्टार्ट डूइंग एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रैक्टिस, सो इट वुड बी अबाउट स्टडीज, इट वुड बी अबाउट एनी थिंग। सो वंस यू स्टार्ट मेडिटेटिंग एंड देर आर डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ गेटिंग ओवर देर। सो देर आर टू और थ्री डिफरेंट वेज। आई विल टॉक अबाउट दोज वेज, द मेथड्स हाउ टू स्टिम्युलेट एंड एक्टिवेट योर चक्रस। नाउ एक्टिवेटिंग योर चक्रस डज नॉट मीन दैट अ पर्सन इज एट अ हायर स्टेट ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस। नो, देर आर टू मेनी पीपल हु हैव एक्टिव चक्रस एंड जस्ट एक्टिवेटिंग चक्रस वुड नॉट हेल्प एनी मोर, राइट? वी विल गो एंड टॉक अबाउट इट। सो टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वॉट हैपन्स, वॉट आर चक्रस, वॉट आर द बीज मंत्रास, विच इज वॉट आर द मंत्रास फॉर इट, वॉट इज द कलर ऑफ अ चक्र, वेर एग्जैक्टली इज इट सिचुएटेड, वॉट एग्जैक्टली हैपन्स वेन यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम विद अ चक्र। सो वेर वेन एवर देर इज एन इम्बैलेंस इन द एनर्जीज ऑफ चक्र, वॉट एग्जैक्टली हैपन्स, वॉट आर द नॉट्स दैट यू सी। यू सी अ लॉट ऑफ नॉट्स ओवर हियर राइट नेक्स्ट टू चक्रस, राइट? सो वॉट एग्जैक्टली आर दोज नॉट्स, वी विल टॉक अबाउट इट, राइट? लेट्स मूव इन फर्दर। तो दोस्तों हम बात करना शुरू कर देते हैं चक्रों के बारे में। सात चक्र हैं, देयर आर सेवन एनर्जी सेंटर्स इन अवर बॉडी। शरीर के अंदर हमारे सात चक्र हैं। चक्र का मतलब होता है नॉट्स, ओके? इसका मतलब होता है गांठें। ये बिल्कुल वही गांठें हैं जिसको हम लोग ग्लैंड्स भी बोलते हैं। कई लोग इसको ग्लैंड्स भी बोलते हैं, ग्रंथियाँ भी बोलते हैं, जहाँ से हॉर्मोन्स का रिसाव होता है। दिस इज दीज आर द सेम प्लेस फ्रॉम वेयर वी हैव अवर एंडोक्राइनल हॉर्मोन सिक्रीशन, राइट? However, it is not exactly the same. Now, the chakras can never be seen with your eyes. Why? Because they belong to a different body. In the same way that we have a physical body, in that same way we also have a ether body, we also have a space body. So, दोस्तों हमारा स्थूल शरीर भी होता है, सूक्ष्म शरीर भी है, okay? So, there are different types of body inside and they are kept active by the way that we use our energy. Most of the people, 95% of the people will never use this energy because it is a royalty to do meditation. It is a royalty to becoming more intelligent or becoming more smart. So 5% in this world, throughout the world, okay, there are people, it is normally said that 5% people in the world will become rich, or the ultra rich people in the world are just 5%. Anywhere in the world you will go, if you find that there are highly creative people, you know, highly dedicated people, out of 100 there will be 5% of people. In the same way, even in the line of meditation, whenever we talk about people, there is only 5% of people who will move further. Most of the people will stay at only one chakra as per their comfort zone. What are chakras? They are energy centers, and whenever you use that energy, you can either use it externally for some kind of esoteric knowledge, so for some kind of energy healing or some kind of activity related to energy outside, or you can use it inside. When you use it inside, it grows inside. When you use it outside, it only grows outside. So normally what happens is when you see the energy moving, or whenever you feel the energy moving, you feel it right next to your spine. So it starts from the base of the spine and then goes upwards. So it is almost like जैसे ग्रेविटी होती है वैसे ये एंटी ग्रेविटी है। एंटी ग्रेविटी की तरह, ओके, ये ऊपर जाती है, नीचे नहीं जाती, ऊपर जाती है ये एनर्जी, और ये आपके स्पाइन से जाती है। सो बिकॉज ऑफ साइंस इट हैज बीन प्रूवन दैट व्हेनेवर यू हैव एक्टिविटी इन योर चक्रस यू विल हैव योर सेरिब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड मूविंग अप वन बाय वन इन टू योर वर्टिब्रेस। सो यू हैव डिफरेंट वर्टिब्रेस एंड वॉट एवर चक्र, वॉट एवर एनर्जी सेंटर इज कनेक्टेड टू अ स्पेसिफिक वर्टिब्रे, यू विल हैव दोज नोड्स। The knots are basically connected to your vertebrae, and your vertebrae are connected to your cranial nerves. So understand this one thing very, very importantly. Why are chakras only limited to human beings? Why are enlightened people only human beings? We never hear that a buffalo or a dog became enlightened, or they are lying in a different state of consciousness. Yes, there are different states of consciousness, एंड ओनली ह्यूमन बींग्स आर एबल टू ट्रांसवर्स इट, उसको अच्छी तरह से ट्रांसफॉर्म कर पाते हैं. सो यू हैव योर ऑटोनोमस नर्वस सिस्टम एंड यू ऑल्सो हैव अ पेरीमीटर नर्वस सिस्टम. ऑलराइट, इट एक्चुअली वर्क्स विद ऑल ऑफ द इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट गेट्स प्रोसेस्ड. सो यू हैव दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड देन यू आर गोइंग टू यूज दैट एनर्जी. Understand this one important, very important thing, that the way that you process information that is coming in, that is the way that you will be using your energies, either into emotions or into intellect or creativity or reproduction or sexual activity or creativity or something else. All right, so please understand it. Whenever you take any kind of information, you are using that information by using your energy and then doing something else. So there is an action and there is a reaction, right? Whenever you stop this reaction, then you don't take the outer information. Whenever there are intelligent people who would never take that information, no books, nothing, no videos, no YouTube, nothing at all. So they will never go and take anything at all. They will only rely on their own individuality. When something like that happens, a man is certainly transported to his internal center. For the first time, a human being gets transported to his own internal center because he is not relying, he is not ready to go and depend on anything which is outer. No religious books, no religion at all. He doesn't even believe that his name is the same name that is being given by his parents. Okay. Very rarely it happens. It does not happen with highly rebellious people. Rebellion does not mean going to your center. Alright. So this is for saints that I am talking about. So normally when people try to look out for their own internal centers, that is the point of time that they try to do something which is against their nervous system. And the nervous system works on parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system so that it can keep you balanced, right? So it will also try to give you stress. At the same point of time, it will also give you a lot of rest. Stress, rest, rest and stress. This is what exactly happens. So you will either be active or you will be passive. So most of the times when you do anything which is highly active, you have to get into the passive modes. It is exactly like darkness and light. So you stay in dualities whenever you are into the nervous system. Ida, pingala, darkness and light, these are the things, right? So sex, and after that you need rest, or you do some kind of an activity, after that you need rest. After doing any specific kind of an activity, which means dancing, singing or anything that involves your physical body, you will require less rest so that you can recover. Now whenever you break this chain and you can understand that there is something which is static and which is called life, prana, that is the point of time that you touch the root where exactly the spine starts and you start transporting that energy upwards, right? It is not going this side or that side, so it is not traveling into any of your specific nervous systems. It is not going over there, it is not working externally, it is now moving internally. There is a way to see that, and that is your cerebrospinal fluid. So it moves like a curve. Okay, that is why it is said that there is a serpent which is uncoiling itself, right? That is also what is called Kundalini. We will not get into a lot of fancy words at all. Today's session is more about science, and if you understand things, you would be able to clear up a lot of things. Now understand this very important thing, that we have to store information into our body, right? So you store information at different levels, your DNA, your angiogenesis, your cells, your tissues, they talk to each other and they have to store information accordingly. Those specific informations are stored with your base energy, which means supposing all your life you have been fearful, so you've been doing everything that is more related to conformism. So you're only on social media, you're only working for people, you don't have any of your own individuality, you're reading books or maybe you're looking into videos, and then your whole personality is something which is all outer extended. In that case, your root chakra is always going to remain weak. You will always be a puppet of people, which means people will do something and then it will excite you or it will irritate you. The porn industry works on this specific pattern because that's your base energy, and that base energy can be used for the first faculty of the mind. Albert Einstein has said very clearly that the only thing that human beings are capable and which is very highly revered, which means it should be respected, is your power of imagination. So your base chakra, whenever we start using it just for imagination, so it could be either sexual activity or power or designation or role or questions or doubt, anything like that. So you're using your base energies for all kind of negative thinking. At that point of time, you are again not using your energy between the center. You are only using it for the autonomous nervous system. This point of time, your base energy starts getting disbalanced, and you will start using your base energy for everything which is negatively attached to this energy. Anger, fear, conformism, societal norms, religious norms, एवरी सिंगल थिंग दैट पुट्स यू इनटू रूल्स यू विल स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग इट एंड एग्जैक्टली दिस ऑपोजिट स्टार्ट्स हैपनिंग ओके यू लीव फियर यू आर लीस्ट बॉदर्ड अबाउट व्हाट पीपल थिंक यू विल स्टार्ट हैविंग योर ओन इंडिविजुअलिटी यू क्रिएट समथिंग राइट दैट्स द फर्स्ट चक्रा दैट्स द रूट चक्रा इट इज कॉल्ड मूल आधार इसका मतलब होता है सारी चीजों का मूल द रूट ओके एंड अंडरस्टैंड दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग बिकॉज वी कॉल इट द रूट ओके ये मूलाधार है इसीलिए हमको इसको जब भी ठीक करना होता है व्हेनेवर वी वांट टू ट्रांसपोर्ट इट और व्हेनेवर वी हैव टू यूज दिस एनर्जी टू क्रिएट सम काइंड ऑफ लॉन्गिंग ओके यू वांट टू क्रिएट एन एंकर राइट यू वांट टू क्रिएट एन एंकर यू वांट टू क्रिएट अ रूट द ओनली थिंग दैट यू हैव टू डू इज सिट योर आईज क्लोज एंड स्टार्ट इमेजिनिंग यूज योर इमेजिनेशन यूज योर विजुअलाइजेशन टू स्टार्ट थिंकिंग दैट यू नो योर लोअर बॉडी हैज गॉट रूट्स एंड इट इज गोइंग इनसाइड द फ्लोर दैट यू आर सिटिंग इन राइट वेरी वेरी सून वंस यू स्टार्ट डूइंग इट एंड यू स्टार्ट इमेजिनिंग इट द रूट चक्र विल स्टार्ट बिकमिंग मच बेटर देयर इज वन मोर थिंग दैट यू गाइस कैन डू इसके अंदर बहुत सारे आसन भी हैं दैट यू कैन डू ओके वन ऑफ देम इज केगल्स विच इज कॉल्ड मूल बंद आई हैव डन अ कंप्लीट वीडियो ऑन केगल्स एक्सरसाइज यू गाइस कैन डू इट इट इज मोर कनेक्टेड टू योर पेरिनियम कमिंग टू द सेकेंड चक्र The color is orange, it is called Swadhisthana, it is more related to reproduction, right? Sexuality, reproduction. So a human being is more related to reproduction because he has to create masses, right? Right from the time since the last 1,000-2,000 years, we have only been into survival modes, which means we have to recreate, we have to have a family, from the family we create a society, from the society we create a complete community, from a community we create a religion. Right? That's exactly what's been happening all this time. From the religion, we also create countries, states, wherever we just lose our identity. So I really would not know whether I'm an Indian or not. Just because staying in a specific kind of a boundary, if you belong to that country, that is something that everyone needs to think about. We are all human beings, and that's why you are all connected to the same part of universe that we call the Earth, right? Perfect. And when you understand that, you will understand that rather than reproducing, there is something else that can be used inside. So you can either reproduce externally or you can reproduce internally, right? And that is when brahmacharya comes into place, abstinence, right? It's not necessary that in order to, you know, uplift or activate the chakra, you need to be having abstinence. ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है कि आपको काम छोड़ना पड़ेगा इसका मतलब होता है काम क्रीड़ा छोड़नी पड़ेगी नहीं आपको कामुकता छोड़नी पड़ेगी यू हैव टू लीव सेक्सुअलिटी देयर आर अदर वेज टू डू दैट इसका जो कलर है ऑरेंज जो हिंदू धर्म का कलर है इसका मतलब होता है क्रिएटिविटी अंडरस्टैंड दिस ऑरेंज कलर इज फॉर क्रिएटिविटी न्यू क्रिएशन ओके इट सिंपली मीन्स क्रिएटिंग योर सेल्फ इन साइड ओके इट इज नॉट क्रिएटिंग समथिंग आउटसाइड राइट What is the best pose for it? Boat pose, Superman pose. If you have seen the Superman pose, you've seen the boat pose. That is something that gives equal stimulation to your spine. Okay? It is exactly somewhere below your navel. आपका जो navel रहता है नाभि, उसके चार उंगली नीचे रहता है. Four fingers below your navel. That's the point that you will feel some kind of throbbing whenever you have that stimulation in chakra. Okay, it is again related to reproduction, power, discipline, roles, role playing. These are the things that you will see. Whenever you have a disbalance in that, you will find people who are infertile, impotent, PCOD and all these things. Okay, because they are always digitally distant. Coming to the third chakra, the color is yellow. Okay, it is your navel chakra. It is also called navel chakra. It is also called Manipur chakra. राइट दोस्तों ये जो चक्र रहता है इसको हम लोग मणिपुर चक्र भी बोलते हैं ठीक है इसका कलर है येलो यानी पीला ओके और इसका कारण ये है कि जब भी कोई इंसान होता है देयर आर टू मेनी पीपल हु गो बियॉन्ड रिप्रोडक्शन ओके सो दे विल हैव अ फैमिली एंड एवरीथिंग देन दे विल स्टार्ट हैविंग लैकिंग टुवर्ड्स नॉलेज द सेम नॉलेज कैन बिकम विजडम सो व्हेन इट बिकम्स विजडम दैट्स द पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम दैट यू कैन से फाइन आई हैव कन्वर्टेड माय नॉलेज इनटू विजडम So when you are able to use your knowledge, whenever you are able to share your knowledge, whenever you are able to integrate innovation into the knowledge you have, okay? Knowledge is no one's hierarchy, which means knowledge has always been here, okay? It is not someone who can say that, you know, I wrote this kind of a Puran. No, it was always over there. Someone had to catch that thought, right? So one, when one gets off that ego, that knowledge has always been here, information has always been here, I only need to innovate it so that I can put it simply and I can put it before people so that people can understand it, right? So when people get completely attached to knowledge, they start feeling that, you know, knowledge should not be shared. It is the information. Someone will, you know, rob my knowledge. Someone will rob my information. People will imitate me. That's when people are having a block with their third chakra. Knowledge, information, wisdom. This is the link between it. And please understand, whenever you see a person who is highly intellectual and they have this clear ego of having a lot of knowledge, that's when you will see that this is a person who got a weak third chakra. right? Now the below, all the three chakras that you have, you know, at the bottom, you know, at the first three chakras, which are at the bottom of your body, right? They start right from the bottom of your spine. They are male chakras. They are active chakras, which means you have to do a lot of things. The upper three are passive chakras, and then you have a bridge, which is the fourth chakra. The fourth chakra is the heart chakra, right? So love, jealousy, doubtfulness, these are the things. Angst, hatred, they come from the negative part of it. So whenever you are having an imbalance in the heart chakra, you will see people who have, you know, who are miserly people. They will never put a single penny. They will never give a single penny. They do not have big heart. And the positive side to it is that whenever you have a strong heart chakra, you will find people who are kind, they are compassionate, they do not worry. They are ready to lose everything that they have in their hand. And that does not mean that a person is spendthrift, okay? There are too many people who are spendthrift. There are too many people who keep on splurging money, and that does not mean that they have a good heart chakra. They only splurge money only on themselves, right? That's not about having an activated heart chakra. Kindness, compassion, those are the degrees when you have good, clear heart chakra. You need to do something about heart chakra. It's one of the most misunderstood chakras of all. Pink color is its color, alright? It is surrounded by green. And I will also talk about the mantras just in a minute. Now, what are the asanas that you can do for the third chakra, okay, which is the Manipur chakra, as well as the fourth chakra? You can start doing bow pose. Bow pose ka matlab hota hai dhanurasana. You can start doing dhanurasana, right? Perfect. Let's come further. One more thing. Whenever we're talking about heart chakra, please remember that there are poses, or there is a mudra. We call it the Tadka mudra. So, dosto, ek mudra hai jisko hum log Tadka mudra bolte hain, theek hai? Aur ye kiya jata hai puri apni bahon ko phaila kar. There is a Tai Chi pose also for it, whereby you inhale, okay, and then you raise your arms, okay, and you literally try to expand yourself. You expand your rib cage. Aapka jo rib cage, jo aapki pasliyan hoti hain, usko aap achhi tarah se expand karte hain, okay? So you expand yourself, okay. And there are times that, you know, you do it even with your mouth open, so like this, right? So that is why it is called Tadka mudra. You can start doing it. It's very beneficial even for your thyroid. So let's come to the fifth chakra, and I will talk about the mantras just in a minute. Fifth chakra jo hota hai wo hai throat chakra. Lack of clarity, mistrust, and of course, you know, bahut sari cheeze hai. Lack of confidence, lack of clarity. Purity is something which is on the positive side. So if a person is meditating on the fifth chakra, which is the throat chakra, they will have a lot of clarity, they will have a lot of confidence, their communication would be clear, their expression would be great, okay? And that does not put, there are too many people who are from the philosophy field or social field, or there are people who are poets and authors. Even though they have a very good throat chakra, which is for expression, they might lack all their other chakras, right? We know too many people, too many authors, too many poets, too many stars, too many celebrities. So even though they have great throat chakra, okay, they must be having, but their root chakra is very weak. So they do everything just for, you know, low time money, you know, some kind of low time money, or maybe low time sexual activities. There are people who are highly creative, but yet they fall down because they have very bad, they have a very weak root chakra. The same thing happens with people who are tantrics. They have good knowledge, they have good wisdom with them, okay? They have very good learning with them. So they have been gifted with a lot of learning from their gurus, but they use it for low time activities, right? That is exactly what happens when you have your weak chakra. So even though you will have your energy which is active on specific chakras, yet your base energy, if it is weak, so you will start looking out for only anger, fear, hatred, worry, sex, and all of these things. Knowledge, attention seeking is also one of them. That's highly rampant. I think so 98% of people today are attention seekers, because on social media you have to have that larger than life image, or maybe you have to project yourself as to being larger than life. Most of the people today have a very weak root chakra. Okay, let's go further. We will now talk about the upper three chakras. The upper three chakras are strand energy, which means they are passive energy, and you have to work on it actively, which means unless and until your bottom three chakras are not activated, never work on the upper four chakras. Never do that. That's exactly what happens. People have lower weak chakras. They never work on it. They never meditate on it. They have never done any mantras, nothing like that. And they directly go on the fourth, fifth, sixth chakras. So there are too many people whom we call people from esoteric cults. Okay, so they will do a lot of things, like, they will do magic, एंड देर आर पीपल हु आर हीलर्स बट दे डू नॉट नो हाउ टू बैलेंस इट बिकॉज वेन दे गो एट अ स्पेसिफिक प्लेस मोस्ट ऑफ देयर बॉटम चक्रास आर वेरी वीक एंड दे कैच दोज एनर्जीज वेरी क्विकली एंड दैट इज वाई वैन यू स्टार्ट कैचिंग एनर्जीज यू नॉट लॉक्ड योर चक्रास दैट्स वैन यू स्टार्ट टेकिंग अ लॉट ऑफ नेगेटिविटी इनसाइड यू एंड यू स्टार्ट टेकिंग द थॉट्स ऑफ पीपल हु हैव बीन विद यू सो इट्स वेरी नेसेसरी दैट यू डोंट डायरेक्टली jump on the upper four chakras. Don't do that unless and until you've not activated the bottom three chakras. And that's the main thing of the session today. Let's go. Finally, you know, we'll come to the sixth chakra. The color is purple. It's the third eye chakra. Lesser said, you know, it would be much better because we all know about it. Most of the people have a damaged third eye chakra. Okay, they've been using it for, you know, this is the chakra which is being used misused or you know it's abused like anything because people directly work on third eye chakra. They start saying that, you know, I can see this thing, I can see colors, I can see lights and this and that, falana and dimka. And you know, things that happen over here that happen wrong is that if you are directly going to work on the top of the building, your foundation is going to be weak. Okay, you will never be able to create a good house if your foundations are weak. Your foundations are completely weak, and even if you gain some knowledge, some power after activating your third eye chakra, you will be a pauper throughout your life. When I say pauper, it simply means spiritually you will remain a pauper. Why? Because these are the upper level chakras are all connected with your space and ether bodies. Okay, you have different types of bodies, physical bodies, space bodies, ether bodies. Okay, sukshma sharir hota hai, sthul sharir hai, dosto ye sare sharir jude hue hain. Agar aap niche ke sharir ko nahi chhod pate to upar ke sharir ko aap kabhi bhi zindagi mein nahi chhod payenge, right? नहीं छोड़ पाएंगे, ये छूटेंगे नहीं आपसे. यू विल नेवर बी एबल टू लीव देम. इट्स नेसेसरी बिकॉज यू नो यू नीड टू हैव अ बिग हार्ट. पीपल हु आर रेडी टू डाई आर द पीपल हु आर एबल टू स्टिम्युलेट एंड एक्टिव देयर अपर चक्रस. दे आर एबल टू ट्रांसपोर्ट द एनर्जी फ्रॉम वन वर्टिब्रे टू अनदर वर्टिब्रे. अदरवाइज द एनर्जी विल गो साइड बाय साइड. इट विल गो हॉरिजॉन्टली इनटू द इमोशंस दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट. पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव इमोशंस लाइक फियर, एंगर, सेक्स, नॉलेज, विजडम, money, power, role, designation, it will keep on going here and there. Family, this, that, relatives, love, romance, every single thing. So it will keep on going horizontally. It will never go vertically. Understand this, and that is why you need to keep on working on it, right? Now, let's talk about the final chakra. It is called the Sahasrara, okay? This is when a person attains oneness with the nature, okay? And this is the final chakra. Too many people have stayed on this chakra for long time, which means one or two births, right? Many a times even more than that. They've stayed, you know, after they've left a body in the past birth, they've stayed in the, you know, in the ether world or maybe the universe for more than 300, 500 years. So they look out for a good couple who is deeply in love, deeply passionate, and that is why meditators are more required in this world because there are too many souls who are just lying over there, you know, they're just flying over there because they need someone who's got a higher maturity, some couples who are deeply into love, okay, and that is something that is vanishing. But digital distraction, there is love which is highly, you know, hardly seen. Friendship is vanishing. You don't see too many friends. Maitri bhav jo hai wo dikhta nahi hai, right? Because hum log milte hi nahi. So there are too many factors behind it. But yes, there are so many communities which are working on it. Yes, there are so many communities which are working on it. And soon there are people who will take birds. And that happens when you have control. So as soon as you start catching up the sixth chakra, you are able to see what's going to happen next and in the next birth, what is going to happen now. And you are able to go ahead and control it. You are able to control it. So you have that in your hands where you wish to take birth. Why? Because you have a map. Now you can see the map. You can clearly see the map, your roadmap. Correct? And yes, you have to, you know, you have to still do a lot of things, which means whenever you are born, you still have to work on your other chakras also. So this is a brief history. Let me talk about the mantras. So the first chakra is root chakra. The mantra is Lam, L-A-M, Lam. Okay. The second chakra, which is the Swadhisthana, the color is orange. The mantra is Vam, V-A-M, Vam. Okay. The third chakra, it is Ram, Manipur chakra. उसका नाम, उसका बीज मंत्र है रम, आर ए एम और आर यू एम एन, रम. ओके, उसके बाद आता है हमारा हृदय का चक्र, द हार्ट चक्र, द फोर्थ चक्र. द मंत्र इज यम, यम, वाई यू एम एम, यम. द फिफ्थ चक्र विच इज द थ्रोट चक्र. द मंत्र इज हम, हम. ओके, एंड यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट व्हेनेवर यू टॉक अबाउट एम, द एम हैज टू, यू नो, इट हैज टू गो इन एन एको. Lam, Vam, Ram, Yam, Hum. and you need to feel those vibration of your mantras while you are chanting those. Okay, let's come to the sixth chakra. The mantra is Aim. Okay, now there could be a differentiation in what I am saying, and there could be few people who must be saying, no, the mantra is not this, it could be Aum or Aim. But you know, I have felt that whenever you say Aim, okay, it actually works on your sixth chakra. And of course, there's the seventh chakra, and the seventh chakra, the mantra is Om. Now let's go ahead and talk about the crystals, guys. So the root chakra, for the root chakra, you can start using red jasper. Red jasper is the crystal. For the second chakra, it is orange carnelian. For the third chakra, it is citrine. For the fourth chakra, it is rose quartz. For the fifth chakra, it is lapis lazuli. It is lapis lazuli. For the sixth chakra, it is amethyst, and for the seventh chakra, it is clear quartz. This is, of course, courtesy my wife, who is a healer, and she knows what are the crystals that need to be taken. Let me go ahead and talk about the poses. For the first chakra, it is Kegels Moolbandha. For the second one, it is Boat Pose, which is the Superman pose. For the third one, it is the Bow Pose, which is Dhanurasana. For the fourth one, it is Bow Pose. For the fourth one, it is Tadaka Mudra. I have shown the mudra. For the fifth one, Sarvangasana, anything that happens on your throat and your shoulders, it takes care of it. Even the Shirsasana is very good for it. Kapalabhati and Trataka are very good for your sixth chakra. And for the seventh, it is Shavasana, right? So this was all about it, guys. Yes, the final chakra. So mantras are Lam, Vam, Ram, Yam, Ham, Aim, Om. Yes, the crystals are red jasper, orange carnelian, citrine, rose quartz, lapis lazuli, amethyst, and clear quartz. And the poses are Kegels, Moolbandha, Boat Pose, Bow Pose, Tadaka Mudra, Sarvangasana, Kapalbhati, and Shavasana. Yes, I will go ahead and put that up on a chart. You will be able to see that chart perfectly well. And I hope this was good for you. I hope it was helpful. Just in case you find it helpful, please don't forget to click on the heart or the like button, okay? Please do that, because I take a lot of care and concern before I create this kind of a content. And don't forget to go ahead and subscribe, because I will be putting it up in two parts. The next session is when I will be talking about the meditations that you can do for each chakra. So if you have a weak chakra, we can talk about the meditations that can be done for that specific chakra, alright? So please remember that you need to click on the like button. Also, if you have any questions, please put them up on the comment section. If you are going to send me a WhatsApp message, please remember that sending me a WhatsApp message, it would be much better that you put that up onto the YouTube video comment. So put that up onto the YouTube video comment, or wherever you see this video, that would be much better, right? Thank you, guys. Bahut bahut shukriya aap logon ka ye video attend karne ka. As I told you, this video is going to be long, but trust me, I tried to put it up all into one single place, okay? Ye sab kuch aap kar sakte hain. So this is it. Just in case there is something, please do let me know. Take care, guys. Thank you. Bahut bahut shukriya. Namaste, doston.